Hello friends, welcome to Civils Manthan. We shall discuss today's important news articles. Now coming to the first news article, that is about the Brew community of the Northeast. So the Brews have rejected the resettlement site offer. So we shall know things about the Brew community, which is very important, especially from Plymouth point of view, and it can also be used in writing main's answer when it comes to issues regarding Northeast, certain issues regarding Northeast. So let us see things about the Brew community. So Brew community is an indigenous community to the Northeast, living mostly in Tripura, Assam and Mizoram. So abhi in teen states ke hain wo, but in Tripura they are recognized as the particularly vulnerable tribal group, that is PVTG. Okay, so in Mizoram they have been targeted by groups that do not consider them as indigenous to the state. Wo Mizoram ke the, but 1997 mein because of ethnic clashes they had to leave Mizoram and they flew to Tripura. So they were basically inhabiting the three districts of Mamit, Kolasib and Lunglei in Mizoram. Okay, since then 5,000 Brews have returned to Mizoram in 8 phases of repatriation, while 32,000 still live in 6 camps in North Tripura. So basically they were from Mizoram and they fled to Tripura in 1997 because of the ethnic clashes. We know that Northeast we find ethnic clashes between lots of communities. So in 2018 June, community leaders from the Brew camps signed an agreement with the center and the two state government, that is Mizoram and Tripura, providing for repatriation in Mizoram. But bahut sare camp president ne us offer ko reject kar diya. Recently in 2020 January 2016, a 4-party agreement was signed between the center, the government of Mizoram, Tripura and the Brew people. So according to this agreement, they will now be resettled in Tripura. Earlier, according to the 2000 agreement, they had to be repatriated to Mizoram, but now they will be resettled in Tripura. Okay, so this is the major difference in the two agreements. Now the stakeholders in this issue expect a package of 6,000 crore from the center. So this agreement mein kuch packages center se wo expect karte hain, jaise for example plots of 5,000 square feet for each Brew family in addition to agricultural land, a stipend of 5,000 per month and free ration for each family for the next 2 years. Brew tribals would be included in Tripura's voter list. So these are some of the expectation of the Brew community from the agreement. But right now they have rejected the resettlement site. This is the current news. So abhi humne yahan kya jana, Brew community ke bare mein dekha, jo ki Riang bhi bolte hain, unka naam Riang bhi hai. Plus they were originally from Mizoram but fled to Tripura. So these are some of the important things that we need to keep in mind about the prelims examination. Now coming to the next news bit, that is the Pokkaldi rice. So this rice variety has emerged as one of the important rice variety, especially in the salty water regions. So the Pokkaldi variety, known for its salt water resistance, so this is a specialty of this rice. And ye kahan hota hai, usually in the coastal districts of coastal paddy fields of Alappuzha, Ernakulam and Thrissur district. So these are the three districts in Kerala where this rice variety is very popular, because ye bahut zyada salt resistant hai, iska ek khasiyat hai, salt resistant hai. So this can grow also in sea water. The uniqueness of the sea has brought it to the, so इसे GI tag भी मिला हुआ है and इसे इस पर continuously research हो रहा है. So in fact JNU के कुछ scientists 6 साल से research कर रहे हैं इसके ऊपर, and उन्होंने यह discover किया है कि इसका जो high expression of specific gene है, that is OSIF, it stabilizes the plant's photosynthetic machinery in the high salinity condition. So this is the reason why this Pokkaldi rice is very famous, especially in the coastal districts where you usually find saline water. मोरेवर इसका अभी कल्टीवेशन यूजली सुंदरबंस एरिया में हो रहा है बिकॉज वहाँ पे भी वाटर लॉगिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द फ्लड एंड ऑल वाटर लॉगिंग इज हैपनिंग एंड इट इज ऑल्सो इट कैन ऑल्सो बी ग्रोन इन वाटर लॉग एरियाज सो दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग स्पेशली फॉर इंडियन फार्मर्स एंड दिस वैरायटी ऑफ राइस इज ऑल्सो रेजिस्टेंट टू फ्लड सो दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट द पोकली राइस एंड इसे जी आई टैग भी मिला हुआ है ये भी एक इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ है एंड ये ओरिजिनली दिस इज फ्रॉम केरला बट फार्मर फ्रॉम अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री आर ऑल्सो ग्रोइंग इट मोरेवर इस पर जो इंटरनेशनल राइस रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट है वो भी इस पर रिसर्च कर रहा है ऑन दिस वैरायटी ऑफ राइस सो एंड नाउ वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट इज टू डेज बैक दिस एक्सप्लोजन हैपेंड इन बेरूट इन दैट इज इन द कैपिटल ऑफ लेबनन सो हमने मैप्स के वीडियो में देखा था कि बेरूट लेबनन इज जस्ट एडजेसेंट टू द मेडिटेरेनियन सी एंड बेरूट इज राइट ऑन द एज ऑफ द मेडिटेरेनियन सी सो दिस इज मेडिटेरेनियन सी दिस इज द एशिया पार्ट एंड दिस इज बेरूट सो लेबनन इज हैज लेबनन शेयर हैज बाउंड्री विद द मेडिटेरेनियन सी दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग स्पेशली फ्रॉम प्रिलिम्स पर्सपेक्टिव जो कि हमने मैप्स के वीडियो में देखा था एंड वहाँ जो ब्लास्ट हुआ दैट वॉज बिकॉज ऑफ द एमोनियम नाइट्रेट विच इज़ ए हाईली एक्सप्लोसिव मटीरियल यूज इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ एक्सप्लोसिव एज वेल एज इन फर्टिलाइजर्स ऑल्सो फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ फायर क्रैकर्स ऑल्सो सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट वी नीड टू कीप इन माइंड थैंक यू